What you don't understand is where everything's leading. When all of the signs you see still point to overload. As you reach out your hand, a shattered picture is seeding.
Don't look to the ocean. I got a big black gun. 7-Eleven and have some food. Knocking on my door. Can't you see I got no money? I can't give no more. 2 p.m. Landlord's banging. Try one more time. You can knock the damn door down, but you ain't gonna get a dime.
today.
Somebody's lying down on the job again. Will you people please stop jumping under my train? Ladies and gentlemen, there will be a slight delay while we hose the flood away. And the clock keeps ticking, so I spend my evening wishing I never was born. Drinking toast to that hood with the hooves and the horns. 'Cause the roaches won't do my laundry no more. And the rats refuse to fix the holes in the floor. Water comes through.
Yeah.
I'm watching over you. You can't see me now, but I'm watching. we are to deal very harshly with ourselves. Anytime we feel sorry for ourselves, we're going to get into trouble. You can't help it. You're convinced you can't help it. The reason is you feel sorry for yourself. You have learned to love that sin. You have become a slave to that addiction. You're lying in bed and your mind begins to work on that just a little bit. But now you're fighting. You're fighting. And yet you let your mind toy with it, coddle the idea, and pretty soon you come to the point where you say, this is too big for me. 20 minutes later, it'll hit you all over again. The problem is that you played with that sin and nurtured that sin in your mind. And you think, oh, wait a minute. Stop it cold. Oh, God, have mercy on me. Don't let me go down that path again. Oh, Lord, have mercy on me. Oh, Lord, give me a hatred for that kind of thing. I'm not going to think about that. And start filling your mind with something altogether different. 20 minutes later, it'll hit you all over again.